my generation, and the fact that writing and songwriting has become very important to me. I couldn't make this record without paying tribute to Stevie Wonder, because Stevie is one of the great geniuses of 20th century, and since he's still alive, 21st century too. In my life, his record, Songs in the Key of Life, was just a mind-blowing thing. I think every song on that record was a hit at some point, some kind of hit. It all got radio play. It was just a work of real genius. One of my favorite songs on that record, if you remember, was a song where it was just Stevie singing with a harp. The song was called If It's Magic. And it was a beautiful, like, if that's what I heard going into Pearly Gates, I know I'm in the right place. Because it was that beautiful. Now, when you're writing and doing arrangements of things, you never know how it's going to go. And this would be an example of a beautiful sort of ballad-like, pop ballad, amazing song that somehow translates itself into a up-tempo, rambunctious treatment, jazz treatment. And I'll tell you that when I was writing this, when I was writing what you'll hear is the introduction, I thought I was writing a new original piece. That's what my intention was at the time. And I liked where it was going, and then I kept getting to this one place about 22, 24 measures into it, and I couldn't hear where this supposed new original composition was going, because I just kept hearing If It's Magic coming out of that. And so I said, well, okay, I'll give this a rest, and you know, maybe it'll come to me tomorrow. And it just kept going on. So finally, after about a week, I just said to myself, okay, this is the new arrangement of If It's Magic, and that's just what it is. So hope you enjoy it, If It's Magic.
Thank you.
Thank you. This next one, it's a beautiful piece by the amazing composer, arranger, someone I admire very much, Vince Mendoza. Vince is the guy that wrote all those full orchestra arrangements for Joni Mitchell about 15 years ago, the record Both Sides Now, and then follow-up record Travelogue. He's just a great, this guy, somebody will say, listen, I need 12 full orchestra arrangements by next Wednesday, and somehow he does it. I don't, it's very daunting writing for 64, 68 piece orchestra. That's all, it's, you know, it's super heavy. He just does it. But there's a beautiful piece of his called Esperanza. Thank you. Thank you very much. So when we get done, I'll be hanging out up here. They set up a little table for me, and I've got CDs for anyone who wants to take one home. I'm happy to just hang out and chat. I'd just like to ask you to help me thank one more time Mr. Stephen Begahole on drums. And Mr. Ben Ralston on bass. I've been embarrassing them the past couple of weeks we've been on the road. Stephen's 25 years old. Ben's 27.
They're getting old.
That's, you know.
Yeah, the clock's ticking for them too, ain't it?
Yeah. No, I know. But it's pretty amazing. They're very, I've enjoyed getting to know these young guys and very impressed with their youthful acumen. So, any good cook knows that if you've got 12 people coming over for dinner, you cook for 15. You always want to have more food than less. You don't want to run out. Making a record is the same way. You want to have more tracks than you can use. That's the idea, because then when you get done, you've got 14 finished tracks. They're all good, but then these particular 9 stand out. I mention it because the piece we're going to close with was one of the more important dedications to me, and we recorded this piece when we made the record, but then it didn't make the cut. And so it's not on the record, but as I said, very important dedication because it's dedicated to Ahmad Jamal. And Ahmad was a very big influence on me. I went kind of out of order. I started with Oscar, as I mentioned, and then I get into a very heavy Bill Evans thing, and into some of his more esoteric stuff. And it was coming out of that that I rediscovered Ahmad and his grooving grandeur. I mean, just the soulfulness of his thing is amazing. So we are going to perform perhaps his most famous piece. Was on the Live at the Pershing record, and I see many of you kind of nodding your heads a little bit, and you know what that is. So I'm going to be obnoxious again and not tell you the title, because you'll hear it. You'll find your way into it. Hopefully I will as well. Thank you. Thank you very much. Stephen Vega, hold on drums. Ben Ralston on bass. Yours truly, Lawrence Hobgood on piano. Thank you so much. It's great to see everybody. Thanks for coming out. We will see you when we come next time.